Welcome to our show here. This is Matthew Wright, and I'm with my co-host Jeremy Elliott. And we're both pleased to welcome all our guests to our show. Please forgive the other shows that failed to materialize. It was not of our fault. There were times where messages came up on Blog Talk Radio that said that they were down for maintenance. While when I asked other people elsewhere to go ahead and log in, you know, try to go to the site, they got the site. So that just goes to show y'all something right there. I just wanted to say that it's nothing at home. Not that we're pussies, not that we're afraid to do so. Why do you think we're on the air right now? You think we're pussies? No. We're going to speak truth to power. And that's what Jeremy and I are here to do in this life. Now, Jeremy, I sense, wants us to step in at this point. Go ahead, man.
Right. Like you said, Pat, basically, the things that we have to say, we're definitely not afraid to speak on. I mean, these are our truths. But the reason that, you know, that we couldn't do other shows or people could get on is the things that we have to say are things that apparently create knowledge and plant seeds in people that grow and materialize things in their minds that other people apparently don't want to happen. And we're here to say, sorry, you can't, whatever belief system you have, you're not deny what is true in your mind, your heart, or whatever it is. We're here to say it. And it's apparently mixing things up. It's stirring things up. It's causing things like we can't get on the radio.
Exactly. Like, some of y'all may have read what I tried to do a show about what happened on one of my previous shows that I did for 2 years, from late 2011 to late 2013, called Spiritual Science Radio, where show after show, and one in particular was disrupted by paid trolls, by paid quote-unquote debunkers and whatnot.
Right.
Especially one in May 2012. And every one of the callers were British. And every one of them were paid trolls. And, as a psychic, and Jeremy's psychic too, and we knew. Although Jeremy was on that particular show, it was just me doing that one on May 6, 2012. And that the other side, the opposition, used that kind of thing against people, tried to destroy people's reputations, hired trolls to disrupt shows, interrupt. "Quote unquote inconvenient truths that they didn't want out there."
When we say oppo, we're referring to the opposition. That's our slang for opposition. But go ahead, sorry, man, I didn't mean to cut you off.
Or you should calm down. It's all right. And that's a kind word for them. They really are the enemy. And y'all should be thinking of them as the enemy, because they are, And I was vindicated a year later after that, when Snowden leaked all these British documents where they were training professional trolls to disrupt talk shows by calling in with prank calls and all this other stuff and psychological techniques. To discredit people.
Matt,
you think that's a coincidence? like a year later, that happens right after I have like 100 plus British callers disrupting a show in 2012. But that's not a coincidence. There are no coincidences. Go ahead, bro.
One thing I never understood, Matt, was that, there's obviously an issue with people opening their minds. I mean, like, even as a young guy, smoking, pot and things like that, I know that the reason that it's not legal per se is because there's a part of the mind to get opened up that, people don't want. I'm going to say people opposite that. They don't want, and you don't have to have pot to open your mind. You have to have some, maybe an ability. Man, I have the ability to say things and do things. I mean, I'm a songwriter also, and my songs tend to do that. Our words tend to do that, and for whatever reason, people, which I don't ever understand why it's so hard the opposite accept our. Why they want to stop people from opening their minds, I guess it's because it's going to change everything up. And it's easier just to have a steady flow of things under control. But the truth, there's a truth. And it's not marijuana. it's not LSD. It's a truth. It comes from something deeper and a stronger power within that you will soon learn about.
Yes. See, like, Jeremy and I have been through so much, we've seen so much, like, what the other side will do, to stop certain truths from coming out. I go through it day to day, so is he. And if you think we're joking, go ahead and take a look at what other people have gone through. If you're speaking truth. Go ahead, take a little look on the internet. Do your own research. And find that we are not joking about this. Do you think we're afraid of the other side? Hell no. We are not.
Yeah. I mean, fear can't be an
option. No. Like, they're terrified of our message. Of what we say. Why do you think they're so fucking desperate? And excuse my language, but those of y'all who haven't listened to Spiritual Science Radio and that was on and so forth, we don't hold back here. Language is language. Word is a word. If we say fuck or shit or whatever, it's just a word. So don't take it personally. Don't be offend it and be like, oh my God, they're using this offensive word, that's a space of like this safe space, like running away, I'm not trying to disparage them either, but the ones who run away, like where they can't face the truth in their face, and they're like, oh God, I have this space. I need a safe space. Oh my God, I can't handle it. Oh my God, those are the ones who are choked. Those are the ones who are brainwashed, And those are the ones that we're trying to reach here, do you understand what I'm saying, bro?
Let me even break it down this way. I don't want to say sorry if we do offend anybody with those type of words, but realize like that in itself is a way of the world that these words bad, this word's not bad. Somebody chose that and they stuck with it, and we're just saying basically like that's part of it. Like we're breaking a mold here. We're saying, and that's such a little thing, compared to the big picture of what's about to be said, I think. But, nobody was upset about some word because somebody told you it was bad. I want to tell you what, nobody gets to decide that. We're sorry to offend you because you've been raised that way or whatever. But it's time to, get past that and take what you could out of this if you can't look past it or whatever. But there's a lot of things that, you know, like that, like who decided that, you know what I mean? And like it's such a little thing, but who decided a lot of this stuff? I mean, so many things they're stuck with and they're just traditional or beliefs or whatever, and it's easy to stay that way. And I think that's what the problem is. That's what the optimal problem is. They're going, wait, you know, if this word gets out or this is said, you know, people will think harder. I mean, that's why a lot of like psychics or people that talk to the spirits on the other side and things like that get, you know, knocked off the TV station after a month or whatever. They don't want people to really believe in that kind of thing. But sure enough, man, spirits are talking to us. They're there.
And but
I
yeah,
mean,
there's
and
truth. Like, you know, look at all the Spirits of Science radio episodes where we sat down and people were calling in and we're sitting there chatting. And you know, look at that. You know, like people's minds were blown. I'll never forget the one where like this veteran, like, you know, like who was in combat in Iraq and Afghanistan. You know, like called in, and I started cutting him off before he even said what he was about to say, you know, and I'm talking about like, you know, his lieutenant, you know, the CO, you know, like the dude next to him got shot in the head and during the battle, you know, I started jumping in, that's right on tape, you know, and like, you know, dude was speechless, you know. Like, and we had a huge audience, so many callers that night. And I think that was in late 2011, maybe early 2012, if I remember right. And, you know, like, it was so clear because, like, the CO wanted, like, you know, all the soldiers reunite. And I made sure that happened that night. And, you know,
Yeah,
how can
I
you
mean, there's a
deny
lot
that?
of
Like, you know, like, dude is left speechless. You know, like he didn't have to even say anything. And, you know, I'm already working the problem. You know,
there's a lot of
like I was
great.
proud to work the problem. You know?
I mean,
Bro.
there's like
Go ahead.
there's a lot of great things of the teaching that we have, man, and the things that we have to say. Like, I don't think we personally would be so negative about the people trying to prevent it being said, except for it causes a lot of grief, misery. Obviously, you know, there's a lot behind that that's disturbed us to the point where now we're kind of irritated, pissed off. I mean, because waking people's minds up can be a really great, beautiful thing. It can be a powerful thing. However you want to look at badass, you know, what badass thing. But like I said, powerful thing. But at the same time, we wouldn't have all this negative stuff to say about the Alpha if we didn't realize that there's people out there trying to prevent, you know, the growth of the mind. You know, because we're at a standstill. If we don't grow, we're already like we're done for anyway. You know, now if we don't grow, we're not going to stand a chance. And here we are. I don't. For some reason somebody doesn't want to stand a chance. It almost seems like it's time to.
We don't
It's probably
grovel
time.
before the other side. We don't grovel other than bow on our knees to the enemy. Well, let me say that
No.
to our audience. You're like, we don't bow before the enemy. In fact, we are their enemy, you know? Like, and they're afraid of us. It's not the other way around, you know? They're terrified of us. And I know y'all are listening right now. And the Oppo is listening, you know? Like, as they listen to all of y'all, you know? Like, this is like why I call it Open Discussion Police State USA. Like, that's part of the reason, you know?
Let me give a good example.
They're monitoring y'all. This is my, you think, see, Jeremy and I come from past lives on the dark side. And this life, we're mixed, you know? We've got light side in us, and we got the dark side memories still in us. So we're able to moderate that out, and we're able to not be able to be taken advantage of. And that's what
Probably
the
so.
dark side grants. in this.
Yeah, I mean, like,
you know,
I believe in person like me and that are kind of like two different sides of it as far as certain things, you know, but like personally, like, I believe in love and peace.
But Jeremy's
stuff,
more
but
emotional than I. Let me jump in with that, Jeremy has more emotion than I do. Like me, I'm more objective. And like all that matters to me is that. And we have a caller. I told you, Jeremy, we're going to get a caller. You know? I don't care if they're troll callers or not. You know? Like, remember I said we're going to roll up intuition. Remember that one in May 2012 where intuition said, let the troll callers call in. You know?
Well,
and let them, you know,
okay.
Just so you have a little recorded record, you know, of it. You know?
Right.
So this is 8:40. Should we take the call now? What do you think?
Let's take the call.
All right, let's do it, man.
Hopefully we can have
it. Hey, what's up, man? Go ahead, man.
Welcome, caller.
Yo,
you there?
I'm chilling. I'm just listening to the program. I'm in the bed with my wife.
All right, cool.
I see you're 804 too, man. You know?
804.
Go ahead, man. Speak up, man.
I'm just chilling, man. I'm in the bed. It's too late to talk. I'm in the bed with my wife.
Oh, he's just listening is what he's saying, basically.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Peace. I'm just listening.
Now, what do you think about what we're saying? Like, does it resonate with you, man? Yeah.
I think he's saying he can't talk because his wife's asleep.
You know, like, you know, and that, you know, the phone's just breaking up a little bit there. You know. But I get it. Like, you know, he wouldn't be listening if it wasn't resonating one way or another. You know?
Right.
Like,
exactly. That's what I was saying.
You know,
intuitively, there's, I feel it. You know, like, the interest is there. You know, like, what we have to say and why. Actually, I believe intuitively, man, that he himself has some things to say, you know, and has wants to be able to be pushed to say them. You know what I mean? And
I want him to say it, but I understand, like, and from your position, Jeremy, man, like, you know, with your wife, like, your kids in bed. Like, I get it, you know? I get that point. Like, I mean, I don't have that against me, you know? Like, I'm here by myself. I don't have a wife or kids. So it's easier for me. But, you know, like, a man has something to say, you know? Like, and I get what he has to say. I sense, you know?
I think he's dealing with the same
you know,
type of issue.
And it's good, man, because, like, it means it's what I said all along to everybody. That it doesn't matter what color somebody is, what somebody looks like, if they're male or female, you know. Like, if you know the truth, you know the truth. And that's it. And the man here realizes the truth, you know?
I had no fear. Yeah, I mean, it's hard to, like, I think he's doing, let me say it. I don't want to say speak for the man.
I've kept him on the line. He's on the line right now, but, like, I understand, you know?
I don't want to speak for him, but it's hard sometimes to have knowledge that you can't say because you're afraid of what people are going to think of you and stuff. But, you know, you got to
But you and I know better than that. Like, we go ahead and speak knowledge. And so, you know,
he's dealing with that a lot, I think, right now. Personally, I think, you know, man, because, you know, really, it's hard.
He's fighting with his wife. Like, you know, there's disagreements there. Like, forgive me, man, for calling this out now, but, like, I feel like that's about what he was about to launch into. Like, you know, there's disagreements there. Like, you know, there's issues in the household with the kids, with the wife, Nina, and more. Like, and Jeremy, like, I felt like you should keep going on this.
Yeah, like,
keep going.
It sounds like, yeah, like, you know, butt heads because of, you have stronger beliefs and what you believe in, you know, but you can't express them necessarily because you have that spouse that, you know, you've committed your life to. So it's hard to push the beliefs because everybody grows at their own speed. You know, you have to let people grow, but at the same time, out of caring and knowing truth, it's hard not to, you know, say it or feel insulted that you can't say it or just freaking want to go nuts or go sit in a corner and mope because you can't, whatever, you know, cry about it, whatever, you know, because you feel the need to help or do something. And it's hard enough to say it, but you got to, everybody grows at their own speed. You can't force the knowledge on someone.
See, he wants to help his people, man. Like, bro, I know you're listening, man. Like, you want to help your people, man. Like, and I get that. And I totally agree with that. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. Nothing at all. You know? In fact, we're here to support you. And,
yeah, like,
I mean,
let me emphasize,
she just sits there and just, like, tries to wipe it away. Like, you know? Like, I get that.
Right.
You know, like, tries to pretend like this and that doesn't happen. But it does happen. You know, do you agree with me, Jenna?
Yeah, you know, I do. And I also wanted to, something me and you talked about before, Matt, I think would help them. Man, I know, I don't know, I want to ask you a question. I know you can't answer necessarily, but, like, I want to emphasize something, man. Like, remember this, that people grow at their own speed. The expectations of each other causes problems. But if you, you have to demonstrate having no expectations before someone can have no expectations of you. You can't blame. So you have to demonstrate no blame before you're not being blamed. You know what I mean? Judge or not be judged kind of thing, if it's biblical, whatever. But listen, man, you know, people grow at their own speed, so, you know, you can't be angry, you know, or frustrated. I mean, you are going to be angry, frustrated, or worried, or whatever. But, you know, try to no expectations, man. Like, in yourself, have no expectations of the people around you. Like, let things flow like water. And it's hard. But at the same time, like, man, if you demonstrate it, you know, it you receive some power in yourself there and gain control of the situation and be able to be that teacher. Let me ask you, I know you can't say much. Are we on to something with this, man?
We are, man. He can't say it. You know, he's worried about waking her up. You know, I get that. You know, like,
you hit a button.
You know, but
like, twice or no.
In his mind, like, I get that. So, like, you know, you know,
it's hard.
Man, like, she's not awake, bro. You know, yet. You know, like, she hasn't reached that point. You know, but you have. And that's what counts, you know? You've reached that point.
Right.
You know, but she hasn't reached that point. But that doesn't matter, you know? Like, she might be your wife, yes. You love her. Yes, you know?
Right. Yeah.
Like, mm-hmm. But, and
counts.
I hope people, yes, you know? You know, but you can't let anything throw you off, you know? Don't, and, like, you want to be here with us right now. If you weren't strong, you know? Like, those who are weak wouldn't be here right now, you know? Like, I've seen too many weak people. And, weak people of all kinds. Even my own family. I've disowned 3/4 plus my own family on this mission. You know, just for weakness, you know? Like, they display weakness and disparage me, and they're gone. And that's it. I don't hesitate to, you know, if somebody questions me, I want to put it as questioning, but it, like, even if somebody in my own family, like, goes after me, I mean, that's it for me. And that's it, you know? And I've done this over and over and over, you know? Like, I've disowned my family for that, you know?
Yeah, no, you want.
Jeremy wants to jump in so bad since.
I'm sorry, I mean, you want to be respected because I feel you in that, like, you have nothing to prove. And when you go against
He jumped off the phone for a second, but he's still listening. I get that. You know?
I got it.
Like,
he's gonna come,
you
he's
feel
come
that
back
too. Like, he's still there. Maybe, like, something happened in the background. But he's still there.
I think that,
you know?
I think with that, I think he's going to go somewhere where he can actually talk. I feel that. Like, he's going to call back.
I hope he calls back. Bro, call back in when you can. Don't let yourself be thrown off by disinfo. You know?
Yeah. One thing about having a wife or children, like, what one person wants out of love definitely is unconditional, meaning, like, at their own speed, they grow and make mistakes, that the person's still there for them. I mean, depending on what kind of mistakes you're making, you know what I mean, that you should stick around as far as that goes, because you commit to that, right? And same definitely with children, but, like, it's hard, man, because, like, showing unconditional love, showing that unconditional love, man, it's difficult, man, when you feel like being downgraded or like your knowledge is not good or smart or, you know what I mean?
One second. All right, I'm back. Keep going.
Sorry. But that's why I think that you're so quick to say to people, you know, look, either, you know, feel me, respect me for what I have to believe, or go on. I mean, and that's an admirable, I mean, but it's hard to do when you commit your life to a woman, you know, and you have children, because that's different, you know.
And see, if that's something I don't understand in this life, you know, like, that's
right.
that you have expertise on, so to speak, you know,
it's an extra weight, you know, so, I mean, it's, you know what I mean, man, like, it's admirable that you can make that stand, you know, it's just hard, you know, if you are in a place in your mind where you want to get married and have kids and stuff like that, you know, you are.
Well, let me say this to the listeners, let me jump in real quick, Jeremy, man.
Yeah,
like,
sorry, man.
For the sake of them, I need to be sorry. For what it's worth, you know, the mission for me in this life is worth so much, you know, that I would sacrifice anything for the mission. Anything. You know? Like, if I was married and had kids, I would sacrifice my own family for this. You know? There would be no hesitation. And, you know, I mean, I know that's brutal, let's say. Like, you know, I mean, it comes off as brutal as hell. And I know it is, you know, but that's the truth about me, you know? That sometimes the mission matters more than anything else. So,
yeah, I mean,
I'll shut up now. Go ahead, Jeremy.
No, it's good. It's chuzzled to you, then, because it's true. Because, the way you are, man, is very admirable, you know, as you are, you know, like, but that's, I mean, you know, some people have that.
It also makes you cruel. It also makes you, it also makes you relentless at the same time, you know?
Yeah, well, that's what
like,
I was going to say earlier.
One
like,
relentless, cruel motherfucker, you know? Like, to be blunt, you know? You know, but the thing is, that's good sometimes. You know, sometimes you got to be, let me quote the song, like that Nick Rose song. You have to be cruel to be kind. That's part of my nature. It's not, let me say to y'all, like Jeremy looks at it from a little different way than I do. And the man that called in a few minutes ago, like, you know, he gets it from a different position, too. He understands Jeremy's line on that, too, better than I do. You know, I'm the cruel to be kind type, and I am that type, you know? Like, you know, whatever it takes to get the mission done. I don't care what it sacrifice is necessary. I'll make the sacrifice. And then, like, it's kind of like, you know, where people think of, like, you know, well, to use this example, like, cops shooting first and asking questions later. You know? Like, I hate to use that example, like, but that's what came to me psycho. You know, but so I'm going to roll it. You know, like, shoot first, ask questions later. You know? Like, well, I'm the type, when it comes to the mission, I shoot first and ask questions later. So, you know,
I mean,
go ahead, Jeremy. I'm sorry.
Well, one thing I was going to say is, like, we definitely both have, because, like, outside of my wife and family, you know, as far as kids can go, I've sacrificed almost all of my immediate family, you know, based on my belief systems, all of my friends and people, because, you know, I'm pretty hard for them to handle as far as whatever, because, I mean, I'm not backing down, you know, as far as who I am, what I believe in. I mean, let me say it like this, you know, we're talking about people getting hurt and stuff or speaking up, like John Lennon believing in peace, right? In all actuality, you know, a human's mind, if everyone sat on the same page, all of us could be peaceful and it would solve all the issues, but it's not going to happen. So it's also don't fuck with the bad side of me, too. Right, you know, outside of my prior commitments, you know, knowing that, you know, humans cannot just commit to peace, you can't just go soft, you know, like that. But, you know, I know that we could, but we won't. You know, at the same time, you know, we have the capability that it ain't going to happen. It's also not worth fighting for at the same time. I mean, you can have it, but, you know, you can't expect everyone else to do it, you know. And you can't have expectations.
Just like I can't expect that manager who called in, like to carry it out. He's torn between loyalties to the family and loyalties to the wife and the kids and all that stuff, you know, between loyalties to what he needs to be true. And,
yeah,
you know, like, I mean, like, and I don't condemn you, man. I can't. I can't. Like, you're on the right path. You would have not called in like that.
Right.
You would have not done that. You know, like, if you weren't on the path to knowledge. You know, but
obviously see.
Like, even now you're in an argument with, like, you know what I mean? I know you, like, she woke up for your argument, you know? Like, I mean, like, you see that too, Jeremy? Like, you know, like, I feel the need to say this. Like, I'm watching it, but I'm not going to call it all out. But, like, you know, it's just like, she's not ready to take it, you know? Like, she's not ready to take on that kind of load, you know? Like, you know, it takes a lot to take on this stuff, you know? This stuff is so deadly serious, you know? Not many people can handle it.
I think a lot of people want to know, like, basically what we're teaching them. The idea of it is, you know, like, I mean, the truth is there already exists in you. The problem is that the fear behind speaking your truth is so much strongly built inside of people today. So it almost like denial becomes a Band-Aid that never comes off, you know. But it's, you know, and you can slowly pick it off and you put it back easier, or, you know, it gets you the right girl or keeps your family around or whatever else. But at the same time, living with that truth hidden under, you know, under this Band-Aid is actually pretty hard to do, you know, because, like I said, knowing that we can have peace is pretty damn disappointing that we don't. But at the same time, I'm not going to fight the war over it. And, you know, so it's like a false idea to create, you know, like, you know, anybody has a great idea on how to do it. John Lennon, Gandhi, they get killed. You know, so, I mean,
well,
but, you know.
Look, in this fight, we fight fire with you know, we're like, they're fighting us with fire. You think we're not going to return fire with fire? Yeah, you're wrong. You know, we're returning fire with fire at this very moment. And you've got to be enraged. You know, you've got to step up. You know, step up.
Exactly.
It doesn't matter. And like, those of y'all who are not afraid to sacrifice, like, make those sacrifices. Do it. Do
they're
it.
Scared, man.
What are you so scared about? Do it.
Yeah.
You know?
They're scared to do it.
Sacrifice. Do what you gotta do. You sacrifice what you gotta sacrifice. You know?
Yeah.
If the
problem,
it, even your own kind is the problem, then you sacrifice.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, that's the problem.
That's the bottom line. You know, now Jeremy has some disagreement with me on that, the some parts. You know?
No.
But
that's
like, I'm coming from the, like, a non-emotional side, like, you know, of things. Like, I'm looking at things so objectively. Like, you know, that, you know, I know that sacrifices have got to be made. And, you know, I know people of this kind, you know, cannot be held back. Like, you know, like when the shit hits the fan, I mean, who's going to come, you know? Like, remember, Jeremy,
yeah,
like, a little earlier on, we were discussing that particular woman, you know?
Right.
Like,
right.
And, you know, like, and remember what we said? Like, when the shit hits the fan, I guess she's going to come running for us, you know?
Yeah, let me clear one.
She's going to recognize that we speak the truth. And,
right,
you know,
let me clear, clear one thing up, though. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's never not for me, you know, just for the caller's sake, because I think you know this, but or the listener's sake, like, it's not that I disagree with anything you say, because I believe what you say is true.
Well, I don't disagree either. It's really, the same,
yeah,
like, you have more emotion than me.
But,
you know,
we just come from two different sides of that field as far as how this is being done, you know, or whatever, but, like, because I want to be able to say, because I give you complete credit, like, I admire things and the way you handle things. I mean, even if I can't, or have to do things differently for my own reasons, you know, because, I mean, that's the problem, we're scared of losing, because, like, you can't tell, you can't even,
not us, you know,
I mean, they,
but, like, why do you think they go full force against, like, those in our kind? You know,
these people got to learn to demonstrate some things first and gain some power. Like, personally, like, if I'm like that, like Matt, like you're saying, like, I'm in a different situation, of course, you know, because I'm married, or I believe in doing that kind of thing, and children and all, having people grow at their own speed, you know, like, personally, I want them to let me grow at my own speed too, but I can't teach them that. So I have to teach that I can let them grow first at their own speed, and see, without expectation is something I'm also working on. You know, it's hard, man. It's so hard, because if you start shouting your truth, you're afraid that you're going to move too quick and lose. So, I mean, and you can't tell them, hey,
and
you
see, I'm relentless. You know, I'm relentless in teaching this stuff. Like, I never, ever, ever stop. And, you know, like, I don't have things like family and kids and wives and girlfriends and whatnot interrupting me. And this, you know, nothing stops, you know? Like, I mean, like, I even dreamed this shit. Like, you know, last night I had a dream, you know, like, actually it was this morning, you know, where, like, it was a screaming match between me and my mom, you know, about this stuff, you know? Like, in the dream, and I'm calling her, like, you know, like, this chumped-out bitch, and, you know, like, a chump and worthless, you know, and that she can't see the truth, so she's not worthy of me. And I'm being honest here, like, you know, I'm not, like, don't judge me on that, y'all, you know, but, like, that's what happened, you know, like, you know, but it was a screaming match, you know, like, and I won too, you know, but, you know, like, I couldn't let somebody question the truth, you know, even if it's my own luck, go unquestioned. So, you see what I'm saying? Like, I don't let anybody go on.
I mean, as a man, you want to feel like what you know, what your knowledge is, should be heard and respected without
and
without question.
She's too weak, you know. Like, and I hate to say that about my own mom, but she's too weak, you know. Like, I hate to say that, but for real, she is weak, and. I'm born of her blood and loins, all that, as you could say, you know, like, and this life is too weak, you know, like, and I call her out on it, you know, I don't care who it is that I call out. If somebody's weak, they're going to be called out, you know.
I mean, the problem is, you wouldn't be so bitter about it, probably, if they weren't condemning you for what you think. I mean, you are educated, like, that's all I want you to know. I don't disagree, because you're an educated, smart, you're a leader. But I think your truth is true. I think it's true. And it doesn't always apply, but I would never condemn or say that that's wrong or that's crazy or anything like that, because it doesn't necessarily always apply to everything I do. Doesn't mean that I should go out there and condemn somebody. You know what I mean?
You're breaking up a little bit, you know.
Oh, I mean, I guess what I was trying to say was, like, condemning people for what they believe messes it all up, because, I mean, like I said, maybe we're
always... Well, I'm
always,
not condemning her, but, like, you know, I'm not hesitating to rip her apart if necessary, like, to get her on board, you know?
No, I think because I was breaking up, you misunderstood what I was saying, because I don't think...
And you think that... That was the opera, right? You know, I get that, but keep going.
That's what I was saying. Like, the problem is, like, you wouldn't even be so bitter about it if they weren't condemning you for what you believe in or saying, hey, that's wrong or crazy or whatever else. I mean, you're a man.
See, I'm the type, like, let me jump in, Jerry, let me jump in. Like,
yeah.
I'm the type, y'all, that, like I answer fire with fire. I fight fire with fire. And I don't care who I fight fire with, it doesn't matter, you know. If somebody questions me, you know, like, and I know they're dead wrong, you know, then I'm going to come right back at them. No hesitation. There's never any hesitation. Like, you know, I go against some of my best friends like this for questioning. It's true, you know. Like, we've been in bitter arguments, you know? Like, and I'm not trying to condemn them, but I'm trying to awaken. And sometimes awakening, like, well, let me use this analogy, y'all. Like, and then, Jeremy, jump back in. Like, listen, let me use this analogy to everybody listening. You know, like, some people are so asleep that they're you literally have to take them by their shoulders and arms and then let's start physically throwing them back and forth, you know, until they wake up. And some people are lightly asleep. And, you know, you can pat their forehead or something like that, or pat their arm or something like that, or even just say a couple words, and then they wake up.
Right.
And versus the ones that you gotta, like, literally shake to wake up. And that's the analogy I like to use, you know, to waking up the sheep. And, you know, and when I say sheeple, I'm not trying to be disparaging either, but I'm speaking the truth. You know, there are sheeple people out there. And,
well, honestly, like you and me in that.
You know? Like, are you going to shake them hard to wake them up, or are you going to buck out, you know, or are you going to, like, shrink from your job and like, say, oh, well, you know, I got to respect them, so, you know, they can't be finally woken up, you know, by shaking them by, like, back and forth, you know? Or, like, you,
right.
You've got to wake people up sometimes. But
I mean, like for instance, here's something even me and you can get something from, I think. Like, you and I, for instance, man, we don't argue that much.
Long time. Jeremy and I have been friends like 1992. Yeah, you know?
Right.
So.
Exactly. And you see, and Matt's always maintained his truth. I've always maintained mine. And even if we have different ideas or go at different speeds, we can still manage to get along because we're not condemning each other. We're just trying to say what we believe, and each other can gain what we need from it, even if we realize it later. A lot of the problem, the bitterness comes from when you speak to somebody and they go, you know, you're crazy. Or they call their buddy up and say, you know what so-and-so just said to me? I look crazy, motherfucker. You know, and you know it. And it's like, why? Because they don't believe in what you believe, or they don't respect, you know, it's just a lack of respect or something, or they're in a position like her parents or something, they can throw you out. You know, they don't have to hear it. You know, they don't have to like it, or the church, they don't have to believe it. You know, they can ban you or whatever, you know what I mean? So we get along because
and,
we go.
And,
hey,
and I'm big
hey.
On that, too. I'm big on respect, you know?
Respect,
I demand respect, you know? I'm not going to lie, y'all, you know? Like, I'm not going to bullshit anybody, you know? I am big on respect, you know? If somebody disrespects me, I'm coming right back at and, you know, with my hands. If somebody says something about me, I'm going right at them. You know, like I'm going for the throat. I'm going cutthroat. You know, I'm just being honest, y'all. I'm just being honest.
I mean,
disrespect
is fire. Disrespect is fire. So if somebody disrespects you, you fight back with fire. Because why give respect to somebody who won't respect you? That's fire with fire. And that's what I was saying. You know, you can have all good knowledge and you can be at peace, but, you know, don't fuck with the bad side of me either. You know, I mean, there's somebody's going to tell me that I'm crazy and make me feel bad for the way I feel and believe. You know, I mean, it's pretty hard to be nice to them at that point. They're not have a bitter taste in your mouth. I mean, like I said, me and Matt have different belief systems that can come together and grow together without fighting for so long. It's easy. For whatever reason, most people around us, they have an issue with that. I mean, I don't know what it is, Matt, but they want to spit fire.
There's somebody who wants to call in right now, by the way. Let me throw that. You know, like, I sense, like, a secret person. Like, go ahead and call in, man. Like, you know, you're equivocating, you know, but, like,
yeah, I mean,
don't give a fuck what people think about you. Go and call
right.
You know, I understand
yeah.
if you can't, but, like, I sent you there, you know, I know you, like, that you're thinking about it, you know, like, Jeremy and I have a lot of abilities, and, you know, and this is one of them. It like give the sense this shit out. Go ahead and call in.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid. You know? Like if you don't want to, I get it. You know? But you know, I'd be proud to take you on the line right now. Go ahead and do it. You know? But go ahead.
I mean, Matt and I are literally like the yin and yang sign. Like together like that. So if any lines get crossed in between, like, we help each other find the extra spot in the middle. You know what I mean? So, but don't fear that we're going to act like, you know, you're unknowledgeable or something or less than or anything because you're not called. You know, you got some knowledge you gave to me. I'm way willing to hear it and learn from it myself. You know, please. You know what I mean, man?
Exactly. See, like, Jeremy and I are not the types to play around, you know? Like, when the rubber hits the road, to use that analogy, you know? Like, you know, when the rubber hits the road, I'm not a tire. You know, like, we're there, and we're taking care of business. And as you see, do you think I give a damn what people think of me? No, I don't. You know, I never have, I never will. And do you think Jeremy gives a fuck what you think about him? No. You know, he does not. You know?
Yeah, I think,
know this shit sounds brutal, but, like, here we are, you know? Like, the goes after us, like, flies and shit. But, you know, here we are.
Here's a good teaching lesson for people, man. Let me do this for a humble example.
Go ahead.
I spent a lot of time in my life, as younger years, you know, not now, worrying about what people thought, you know what I mean, trying to please, and I realized how much I was denying of myself, you know, and now, as a, you know, I've lost a lot, speaking, because, like Matt said, when it comes to it, and the truth has to come out, I've lost a lot, having to be cornered and be like, here it is, I've lost a lot. Now, the only, you know, I'm married, I have 6 commitments to my wife, is, you know, we have ups and downs. Like my children, I know that they're still growing. I got a responsibility there. But at the same time, like, I shouldn't have wasted so many years trying to impress my parents or, you know, all these people, man, because every one of us is smart as we are. You know, we're not, we shouldn't be rejected. Like, these are things that are taught by the world. Like, remember Matt was saying the other day, we agreed, like, school is like a setup for failure because you got to do something to make an A or to be good and to make an F. Like, you're going to say, you got an F, you're horrible, you know. So, like, the teacher's like, you know, like, there's something negative there, right there, you know, that you can be wrong. You know, there is no right or wrong. I mean, if you want to finish school, you got to answer the question how they want you to. But that's because it's something that's in a, you know, this is set in a book at school. You're not in school no more, you know what I mean? You have no reason to answer it like they need you to. You know, you answer it how you want to, you know, and without fear. And if you learn different tomorrow, the next day, your truth changes, it's allowed. You know, you're not a hypocrite because your truth changed. But, you know, people want you to believe so, too. It won't change the truth. You know what I mean? It won't grow. These are the things that people do. You know what I mean, man? I'm trying to use an example because I wasted so much time in my life. And now that I'm here, I'm still learning everything. Changes. Things change still. But, you know, it's better. But that's because I start realizing, you know, what I have to say is thanks. You know, I'm worthy enough to analyze, break it down, spit it out myself. I don't need anybody to help me. You know, nobody. You know, but before I always felt like, you know, if I didn't have somebody there agreeing or helping me, who knows, you know. But you know, you already know the truth. You know, there's no right and wrong. You know, it's just, it is what it is, you know.
It's just that right, like, and right and wrong is the definition of what a person's mind thinks right and wrong is defined as. That's it. And, you know, right and wrong, like, is what you think right and wrong is. That's it. And
yeah, so what you think, yeah.
Can I jump in with, like a little message here? Like, I want to address, like, because there's Black Lives Matter activists listening right now. I know it. You know, and I want to talk to them directly, and I want to say something about this, and, you know, like, let me address y'all directly, you know, like, y'all, like, started out, it's a good move, you know, like, it's the right thing, you know, but y'all are being hijacked, and you cannot let that be, and if you don't address control of the hijacking of that movement right away, you know, then y'all are lost. Y'all's cause lost. And, you know, do you think the Oppo wouldn't take infiltrators and instigators into y'all's movement to use you? If you think that they wouldn't, you're wrong. You know? Like, I agree with what y'all are saying. You know? Like, you know, but the thing is, every life matters. And, you know, and here I am saying that. You know, I'm coming right out. Like, we're going political Jeremy right now. You know? Like, you know, I hate to do that, but here we go. You know? Like, you know, and like, every life matters, you know? And what I fought for so long is that every life matters, you know? I've done that for years before any of this ever happened. And then here we are where, like, it's a divisive shit where y'all's statements are being used against you. You're being hijacked and being used. And I just need y'all, like, to recognize that, you know? I don't judge anybody. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a flying fuck what color somebody's skin is, what sex somebody is, if they're transgender or bisexual or whatever. I have never given a fuck about shit like that. And Jeremy can tell you that. You know? Like, never have I given a damn about shit like that. But I hate to see a movement like this be hijacked. You know? Like, being used by the Oppo. And, you know, y'all gotta wake up. Wake up. Wake up. You can't let yourselves be used as chumps, as tools, as pawns. You cannot let that happen. You know? Like, I love all of y'all. I don't care if you're black or white or whatever. You know? But I'm trying to school y'all. You know, on some knowledge here. That's, you know, think about what I said. Think about it. You know, those of y'all who know that you know that you know will recognize what I said to be true. If you don't know that you know that you know, then you won't.
Yeah.
But I'm hoping that those who know that they know will. You see what I'm saying, Jeremy? I know you do.
Yeah. Yep. I mean,
I love you guys. Like, you know, like, but black lives have to matter to everyone, not just if, like, some cop kills, a black life, you know? Like, and I said that for years before this movement even came into existence. And a lot of people can attest to that. I'll bring people on the air to attest to that. You know, like plenty of people, black and white and more. You know, like I've always said that. You know that. Jeremy's seen, you know, talking about like, you know, like that, like the stupidity and like, you know, of like, you know, just like, you know, you see me. They go out killing each other if you do this shit, you know? Right. And this goes for Hispanics, too, you know, and white people. Like, white people dumb it, too, you know? And we're white, and we're calling out white people. So can you call us racist? No, you can't, you know?
Yeah.
Like, we're calling out white people for this shit. You know?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. Please don't.
You cannot.
Please don't put me. I mean, to cut you off, but it's like you led right into what I was going to say too. Because like, please don't put me in the same boat. If one white cop kills a black guy, and immediately a whole group of guys decide that you know the white people are bad. You know, please don't put me in that boat because it wouldn't have been me. Like, or the Muslims.
That's the hijacking I'm talking about.
Right,
like,
exactly.
Like, think about it. Like, you know, what I teach people is that, like, you saw my Facebook post in the past couple of days, and I think that, like, just, you know, that the fact that to understand and destroy the enemy, you become the enemy, you know? You exactly. Become them from, you know? Like, and you think, like, y'all guys, like, on that movement, that the enemy is it becoming one of y'all for a moment to figure out how to destroy you? If you think that they're not, you're sorely mistaken. You know?
Yeah, Matt, you're not,
like,
you're not the enemy.
The smart
you're
people
the,
go after the enemy like that. You know? Like, you know, if somebody's your enemy, you go after them, becoming them. You know? You take them and you become them. And you think how they think. And then from that, you figure out how to destroy it. And, you know, I'm trying to help you all not be destroyed. You know? Like, I'm trying to help you all move. You know?
Thanks,
for
Martha.
Real.
Thanks.
You know?
Thanks.
And we're sitting here, both of us are white, and we're sitting here figuring out, like, helping out, you know, like, you know, the Black Lives Movement. But the thing is, though, we don't look at race. None of me, nor you, me, nor you, Jeremy. You know? See, I'm on a rant here. I'm sorry. But, like, I feel like I'm Alex Jones. Well, listen, it is so rant. But, like, maybe I need to, you know?
I feel like
but you all cannot continue saying that, you know, Black Lives Matter when y'all continue to kill each other, you know, at your own pace. You know?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not being political here. I'm being honest. You know? Like, I don't care what, like, if y'all want to trash me for what I said, go ahead and fuck me. Go ahead and do the fuck.
Every life.
You know?
Every life. Matter.
You're very welcome to go ahead and try to do that. You know? You know? But I'm trying to help you. You know? I want to help you. You know? Like, that's it. And, you know, you cannot continue to destroy each other's lives and then claim otherwise. You know? Just as Jeremy just said, like, a white cop takes a black life.
Yeah.
Like,
don't
you know?
That boat,
like, you know, even though it might be unjustified, and a lot of times it is.
Sure.
Unjustified.
Absolutely, yeah.
You know, like, you know,
anger.
I'm going to come right out.
Okay.
That too. I'm not going to bullshit that. You know, a lot of times, it's completely unjust. I mean, you know, a great majority of the time, actually, is what I get tightly, it's unjustified. You know, but yet, you know, you're like, you're going to be held hostage to that, you know, to that, to people saying, like, how can you say that? Y'all kill each other.
Let me help explain.
I mean, Jeremy, you and I are getting, like, you're like cutting to the core here tonight, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
I mean,
but the thing is, like, it needs to be done, you know?
I think what's the thing.
I mean, and Jeremy and I, like I said, before you speak, let me say it again.
Yeah, go ahead.
We are not racist. Anybody who looks up any of our history knows that shit. You know, we are not like, you know, we are here to help.
Not hateful.
You know, we're very, very, very strong beings. You know, but yet, like, we give our strength to those who deserve it, you know? Like, you know, y'all deserve it, you know? Like, sometimes you might lend our strength to other causes, too, you know? Whoever deserves it, like, righteously, we're going to give our strength. Go ahead, Jeremy.
It helps because, I mean, I hear that we have to free the hostage on, because look, if you're mad at somebody for killing somebody and you kill them for doing it, I mean, you're going against your own beliefs. You see what I mean? Like, don't do that. You know what I mean? If you believe in killing, fine, kill. it's that's on you, right? But you can't say I'm mad I killed so and so, so I killed them back. You know, that doesn't help anything. That puts you in the same boat. Like, you're going to be held responsible for that. Like, think smarter. Like, just know it's hard. Yeah.
And the responsible, what he means is that it's not, it may not be in this, it may not be like you get locked up or whatever, you know, but
right.
The thing is, so after leave body after death in this life, you know, well, you know, the karma might come for this, you know, for you in this life, or it might be 10 lives down the line, you know, like, but you will be made to be held accountable if that's what helps. What holds firm. Jeremy,
don't give
anybody.
Go ahead. I was saying, don't give anybody reason to use you as a scapegoat for and a blame, because like blame is a problem. Matt, I wanted to say that so bad. Like, this is what keeps coming to me. Like, you know, like I said, I hate to use this example again. Like the Muslims flying the plane. Everybody hates all the Muslims all of a sudden. That's ridiculous. Don't put, you know, if I was a Muslim,
you know,
it's a guy that we're in the plane, you know, like, ask them, but, you know, you can't, so they point fingers at the people they can, you know, it's easy that way, but it's not okay, because you don't want to be blamed for what every white person does, right? Or, you know, if it's negative and you don't believe in it, so how can we blame anybody? I mean, blame is something that we've been taught. That's on our hostage coat. You see what I mean? It's holding us down now because we spend so much time in our minds even just going, well, this is why this is. This is why that is. This is wrong because so-and-so made it wrong or whatever. Okay, now that we've got past all that, blame, okay, we believe you. This is, you know, now, set the example, see, and that's the problem. Things get the best of us, you know, and it's easier to get out of the situation point, you know. But at the same time, like, fear, you didn't act that up because you get scared, because you don't want to, you know, at the same time, you know, you don't, because of one person's bad actions, you know, you're going to go hide, you know, because of the... You know, like I said,
let me jump in. Like, you know, and the thing in Baton Rouge, all right? You know, like a black dude goes out, okay, and starts killing cops, and then, like you know, he's angry about Black Lives Matter and whatnot, and then he ends up killing a black cop in the middle of, you know,
right?
Now, you know, like. Now, what does that say? You know, he didn't mean to do that. He was just going after everybody. I get that from the spirit. You know, like, you know, but the thing is, though, like, what does that do? Do you think that helps that? You know, like, or does that destroy your mood? You know, like, you know, it's already being used against you. You know, I've seen that. You know, they use that against. The fact that, like, a black cop, like, ended up getting killed, and then, like, you know, conservatives are that against them, you know? Like, you know, like, you know, you say Black Lives Matter, you're black, and you kill a black cop, you know? Like, you know, I mean, like, and I can't say I disagree, you know? Like, and I'm not condemning either, you know? Like, it's just like, you know, like, they don't see that kind of thing is a sabotage of their movement, you know? You know?
It's a trick, too.
Like,
I mean,
how
fun,
could you have,
that
you know, like, you do that, and, like, how can you not be sabotaged? If I was on the opposite side, you think I wouldn't use that to my advantage? But the hell yeah, I would, you know? Like, you know? Like,
yeah,
I'd use that to destroy your cause. You know, if I was on the opposition side, which I'm not, you know, like, but I can think like it. You know, I can put myself in their place. I, like, You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, it's like,
I'm on a rampage tonight, Jeremy. We have a caller here, but it's probably a troll call. But, like, let's see. You want to put him on?
Trolling, let's talk.
Yeah, I know what it is and what's going to happen, but let's see. You know? Like, you feel that? All right, here we go.
Welcome, Tom.
All right, go ahead.
Yes, I appreciate your show. I just hear a little bit about your show, but, I mean, it seems you are talking about Police State USA and talking about, I believe, police brutality. Is that true?
Yes.
We're talking about, both sides here. Like, we see from the side of the police, the way they're looking at things. And we're also looking at the opposition side to them. And we're trying to be equilateral here.
Right now what happens is police has a very high tension. They have very much, they catch anybody.
But do you think we're condemning them? Because we're not.
Let me tell you what I meant, and then you can tell me what your opinion is. Police has a lot of pressure on their hands. Police, because as soon as they stop anybody for traffic stop, they presume that person is nasty. That person is bad. Until even they check their information, etc. So at the same time, we are Americans. Unfortunately, we are under drugs. It can be medical drugs, or it can be drugs that we obtain from non-medical centers. So.
Exactly.
Anybody can react to the police differently, at any time given. Somebody maybe stop, nice, okay, yes, sir, bye, or I don't have to exercise anything to talk to them. I exercise my amendments, my constitutional rights. That's why.
Absolutely.
But every case is different, and these people, it's worldwide. It's not only United States of America. Even in Canada. I don't know if you travel to Canada or not. If you stop by police in Canada, or even in Europe, or even in UK, or even in Africa, even in Bangladesh, even in India. It's better you talk to the police nicely and ask, whatever they want you, try to cooperate with them. It's much better you be off than not cooperating with them. Anywhere, worldwide.
Can I say something on that? I've had a lot of experience on interacting with police. So is Jeremy. I know how it is. We have to interact with police.
You are cutting.
It's about respect. I understand that. I totally understand that, because if I was in the officer's place, I would demand respect out of people too. I don't disagree with you at all on that. I can't disagree with that. I would demand respect too. And, the ones who disrespect, are the ones who get their asses beat. You know, and I don't disagree with that either. You know,
let me say it this way too. Now, like one, you know, like in the situation where the police shoots the man, you know, and it's unjust, right? You can't blame all the police with him because one man acted like an idiot. Because all the rest of them, they just disagreed. But we can't ask them all. We can't blame the police as a whole. We have to blame that one man who acted like an idiot, you know, and stick to our beliefs behind everything else, you know. If that one man did something unjust, then that's the man you blame. You can't blame the color. You can't blame the status, the job, the belief system, the religion. You got to blame the man. But if you react just like that man does, then you yourself are also becoming that man. It is a trap that is set because that's how we're taught. You know, I mean, that's what's done. I mean, and especially in the lower class, like in the ghetto. I mean, it's on. But at the same time, you know, it doesn't demonstrate anything good. It just has a whole bunch of extra lives being killed over one man who acted like an idiot. You know, and it's a responsibility that man took advantage of. Because you're supposed to be able to go, yes, respect the police, because they're the police and all this, but, you know, you have to be knowledgeable of the fact that, you know, they're human too, and they may be judging you, and they may be quick to draw blood, you know, and they might want to shoot. You never know, they're only human.
But the thing is, like, from the start of the show, Jim, and I, like, always, like, thought about it, and, like, you know, I've always wanted to come out in the air, and I'm going to come out there and say it right now, you know, that, you know, every color is welcome here. Like, I want cops to call in here. I want Black Lives Matter activists to call in here. I want everyone to call in here, you know. I don't care who you are, you know. Like, I want you all, like, to share your opinion, you know. Like, now, he's calling in from another country. You know, like,
where are you calling from?
I am calling from UK, sir.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, from the UK. Okay, all right.
Right.
You know, like, what I'm trying to say is that, like, my thought about this show the whole time is like, as I said, like, we welcome every caller. I'm not condemning anything. Jeremy's not. I'm not condemning anybody for anything. You know. Like, I want, like I said, I want cops to call in. I want Black Lives Matter activists to call in. I want whoever to, you know.
In the United Kingdom and Europe and everywhere, I mean, you have to be, super nice with the cops. Otherwise,
and
you get trouble
no matter where
your land is.
Like,
even
I know how
not to
get my ass because like, psychically, like, I know, like, if I was a cop, like, and somebody disrespect me, I'd beat the shit out of them, you know? Like, and I get that. I totally get
you're,
that. You think I'm good
human and you abuse your thought, right?
You know? Like, I would do it. You have to learn to respect the laws of the country. You know?
Or learn the laws of the country that you travel. When you travel, you have to learn the laws of that country. You have to know everything. I mean, you cannot just come into United Kingdom and then you want to act like, you know, to be like, say, in America, of course the cops here is going to arrest you and do everything in their power, and then you get later on cry wolf, oh, it was racism, or it was this or that. No. It's better you respect the law, I mean, city law everywhere in every country you live in. You must know your rights, of course, but at the same time, you must obey the laws. I mean, when there is a red light, Do you pass the red light? I'm sure many people they do, but I mean, again, why they say red needs to be stopped? Because if you pass, then you make a crash and you kill other people, you kill yourself too. So respect the laws. And I mean, yes, in between that,
I agree with that.
There are some cases that, you know, happens around the globe. Whether it's in Jamaica, you're in Jamaica, it was just a few days ago. There was a Jamaican police shot this 5-year-old kid in Jamaica. So, you know, so are we going to say that? It was a few days ago. It's therefore. Jamaica, are you going to say it was racism or it was this, it was that? No, they're all black. I mean, they're all, I mean, Jamaicans are called, dark skin. Let's put it that way. So we cannot say that. I mean, but there is a massive amount of tension right now in Jamaica as a result of this, police officer shot 5-year-old Jamaican. So again, we see things can happen anywhere in the world. But again, we cannot blame everybody and say,
we're not blaming everybody. Why did the 5-year-old get shot though in Jamaica? Like, I haven't heard about that. Like, did he have a weapon? Like, I mean, I'm being straightforward here. Let's pause. Not by.
Let me say something. The
5-year-old example.
The question is, mistakes happen around the globe, everywhere,
absolutely,
in each land, but we don't see them. Yeah. We don't read about it. You know, if you don't read about Jamaica, every day the news in Jamaica, really you don't know what the hell is going on in that part of the world, or vice versa, any other country. But what we...
Here's the problem, I think, with what's going on with the issue that, you know, where they're coming up with Black Lives Matter, because what happens is that, man, maybe everybody standing there saw the police officer unjustly shoot the man. Now, everybody in the ghetto could have run up and said, hey, or wherever they live, could have said, hey, we saw this. This is how it happened. It was unjust. Now, it's their word against the police. Now, they're mad because they saw it. They're not stupid. They said, hey, it was unjust. Now, they're saying, oh, well, we panicked, or, you know, it wasn't unjust. And the problem is, you're calling a whole bunch of people dumb, and they're going, hey, you shot my friend. We saw you, and we can't do nothing about it except for let them die and let you be the law and the official end rule answer. No, it's not like that, because we saw you, and that's the problem. And they're mad because, you know, it does happen every day, and I think most of the time it's justified. But when it's not justified, people stand up and they want justice, and they demand it. But being where they're at, not being police officers and having no control over if you go to jail or not, and they don't get to carry a gun and run people's lives, they can't say, hey, you know, you killed my friend unjustly. They go, no, I didn't. And that's it. You know, it can't stop there. That's why people are so mad, because it does stop there. And also it's an insult to people's ability to see what happened and be knowledgeable. So it's like, okay, now we're seeing that because of who you are, you get to walk over us. And that's the problem with a lot of things. You know, right. We'll follow the law, but we'll follow the law, but at the same time, you know, we can't expect, you can't fuck with a man with a gun. You can't fuck with a man who decides if you go to jail or not. And you can't turn your back to a nervous cop because he might shoot you and get away with it. You know?
Well, let me jump in here. Like, hear me. Let me jump in here. You know, like, in this thing in Jamaica, like, I'm going to have to look it up, but, you know, with the five-year-old,
right.
Like, you know, if I was a cop and then, like, you know, like, let's say, like, you know, a five-year-old was shot by his parents, you know, like, to shoot weapons and whatnot, you know, and that's happened, you know, it's happened plenty of places. Who doesn't know that? You know, like, I mean, if I was in the cop's position, I would kill the five-year-old. You know, like, there would be no hesitation. And, you know, like, let me just say that, you know, because I want our cop listeners to know, you know, that we're not against them. We're not against the Black Lives Matter listeners either. You know, like, we're not against really listening to anybody, you know? Like, but, yeah, if a five-year-old, like, pointed a gun at me, I would kill him, you know? Like, as simple as that, you know? Like, so I can see that, you know? Like, I mean, and some countries, like Brazil and whatnot, young people are taught like that, you know? Like,
you see,
in Jamaica, they too.
Yeah, Jamaica police remind citizens of their responsibilities during an arrest. Following a hostile police-citizen interaction in Gordontown, St. Andrew, the police are reminding members of the public about their responsibilities and that the lawman during an arrest or an operation. Citizens are being reminded that it's their responsibility to not run away from approach by the police. Number two, show no hostility and comply with the instruction of the police. Number three, listen carefully to all the instructions or requests made. Remain calm and remember that there is nothing to fear. Citizens are also being asked to do the following. You have right to ask what you are being arrested and searched for. You have right to refuse to answer any question until your legal representative is present. You may obtain the name, rank, regulation number of at least one officer on the scene. If you taken into custody, the police are responsible for your safety. Citizens must not hinder the police when they are arresting or approaching anyone, as this constitutes a criminal offense. So do not force.
So you say you're from the United Kingdom, right?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, go ahead, sir. Yeah.
Okay, I just wanted to clarify that. You know,
but I understand,
the UK, Jamaica is one of the United Kingdom's colonies, correct?
That's true. Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
So basically, you know, whatever I read for you is universal. It applies to you as a citizen of America, as a citizen of UK, as a citizen of European Union, as a citizen of Africa or Asia or India or China. So anywhere in the world, you have to follow this guideline. Otherwise, you know. I mean, am I right or wrong? If I'm wrong, correct me, please.
You heard me say that like, if a five-year-old pointed a gun at me, I would kill him, you know? So I've got, like, absolute agreement there. Even a five-year-old pointed a weapon at me, I would do what's necessary. So
right now,
I don't agree with that. You know,
right. What I'm saying is, like, if somebody thinks one man does something unjust, it doesn't matter what their position and stances are, you know, because you can't blame all the police around them and be mad at the police because one policeman does something unjust. I mean, if a librarian shot a man, would you hate all the librarians and want to kill all the librarians? No. But, you know, you still respect the library, you still respect the police, you know, but the person who does something unjust, you still have the right to question them. And if you can't speak out and say that they've done something unjust because of their position, it causes a problem. It makes you fear that, you know, that the people that have control of peace are not acting right. You know, it makes you fear that. I mean, and some people should all of a sudden be afraid of all the police, just like the police are afraid of all the black people, maybe because one police got shot by a black man. You know what I mean? And I think that's silly. You know, but you can still blame the one person that acted unjust, you know? But you have to consider the reasons of why they did it first before you can say it was unjust. You can't say it's because they're a police or not a police or what. You have to be able to weigh them out. You know, it's never about the police, you know, because what they're saying is, what I'm saying is basically, you can't judge a group because of one person's actions, you know? All Muslims because of one radical, all police because,
Can I ask something? Are you a police officer? By the way,
myself.
I'm
no.
Just
asking.
Yeah.
No. I'm just investigative reporter. That's all.
Okay.
Got it.
No,
I mean, you realize that.
My name is Mazda. My name is Mazda, by the way. Mazda.
Sure.
Nice to meet you.
Do you see that? Go ahead, Jeremy. Sorry, I just don't want anybody to think that this was about, because you put on there, you know, police state, you know, or whatever, we're talking about police necessarily. No.
Yeah, see, I wrote that for a reason, you know, because I'm trying to get everybody on board here. Like, I want everybody of every stripe or every color, you know, like cop or non-cop or whatnot, like, to pay attention to, you know? Like, I respect everyone.
What I read for you guys, I would like to discuss everyone. I mean, was it justified? Is it normal? Is it right? I mean, you know, something like that, really, they should put for you as an American citizen. I mean, they show, okay, what your rights are when the police catch you, what they want you to do. You know, similar things, you know, in Jamaica, they put all these things, which is also apply for everybody, but, you know, maybe yours is a little bit different, but show no hostility.
Did you hear me say that, like, the Jamaican police, like, if I was one of them and a 5-year-old pointed a weapon at me, that I personally would kill them, you know, for doing that, if I was a Jamaican cop, you know, and it would be justified, you know, like, I mean, how can you say
personally,
that, like, I'm not unbiased, I am biased, I'm not biased, you know,
if I was a cop personally in that situation, I might get caught up thinking about it too much or get shot by the 5-year-old, you know what I mean? Personally, because that's the kind of person I am, right, Matt? You know?
Jeremy and I are not anti-police, believe
it.
Like, we're not like that, you know? Or title might be, you know, Police State USA, which, well, in a way it is, but, you know, not in the way we're talking about here. But, you know, the point is, like Jeremy and I, we probably react the same way, me probably quicker than him, you know, in the same situation. No?
Right.
We get the cop's perspective, you know?
Right.
Clearly.
We get it. I think what we're talking about more or less is the mindset of how, you know, the right, of course, and unfortunately in this world, like, you know, fortunately we have the police for many of reasons, but unfortunately sometimes because of human judgment, people go to jail for the wrong reasons. I could say that either way, and I think it's just based on each individual. Outside of that, there's a lot of people policing the minds of people with right and wrong, not the police, but just teaching in general, our guilt of making people feel a certain way based on somebody believing they know what's right and wrong. I mean, outside of the police. I mean, yes, we have to follow the rules and laws. We have to act a certain way when approached by a policeman. But outside of that, who could tell us and make us feel a certain way about our beliefs, you know, other than that, you know what I mean? And so, and we feel like people do police that kind of thing, as a word we use to make people decide their how they're going to act in this world, as far as their jobs, their life, their religious beliefs, all this, their guilt, their preferences, life, style of change. I mean, it prevents them from changing and growing because of fear, because they don't want to be wrong, or, you know, or they feel like they're not worthy. And people have obviously gotten to the minds of people and policed how they thought. We have no, nothing against the police, you know, but at the same time, you know, if one policeman shot something unjust, you know, we might have something against him, you know, or anybody shot anybody unjust.
Are you still there? I'm sorry.
You know what I'm saying.
I need to jump in like that. Like, you know, the phone charger can't just kind of keep on going.
Yeah, bottom line is this, that yes, there always will be some error in judgment. Yes, there will be sometimes some kind of, shooting, etc. happens. But again, they have to go through the, you know, their supervisor, an investigation through a State Department, etc., etc. So, you know, I mean, you have to have some faith sometimes in your systems or the systems where you're living right now. I mean, whether it's Jamaica, UK, you know, US, Canada, wherever you are, you must have a faith in that system. And, you know, it's best interest for everybody to cooperate fully with the police and army and National Guard, or anytime, anything happens. I mean, it's better to, you know, have them in your side.
And just, like, put your hands up and, like, you know, and go with the command, correct? You know, right. I'm not disagreeing with you.
Have them on your side, then not to have them on your side.
Can I
use
an example? Have you heard of like the that situation with that 12-year-old in Cleveland, like the other year that Mayor Rice, correct? You know, I think that's justified. You know, let me jump in. That's justified. You know, I saw the video. Like, you know, it may have been a BB gun, and it was, you know. But the thing is, when you look at the video at close up, he's pulling it up, you know. And if I was a cop in that situation, I would have killed him, you know. Like, and that's that, you know. And, you know, I know I'm being brutal here, you know. But, if, you know, my mind's able to put my... I'm able to put my mind in their place, you know?
Yeah.
And
yeah, let me say this on their behalf.
So I don't think like I'm judging them, you know?
I'm going to let you keep talking, Matt. Just let me say this on their behalf. Yes, it was unfortunate that it was a misunderstanding. The boy did not have a real gun. but at the same time, you know, reaction from a police officer seeing a gun pulled at him is very justified and natural. It's, yes, unfortunate misunderstanding because it could have been prevented a killing, but somebody behind that child should not have let him walk out the door with a gun that looks realistic and point it and wave it around. You know, so there's other people
yeah,
to blame.
Yeah, like,
that.
You know, his mom let the orange tip come off of that thing. You know, like that orange, you know what I'm talking about, Jeremy? Like, you know, the little orange tip to let people know it's not a real gun. You know?
Yeah.
Like,
Exactly. People make human error. I mean, like I said, it's a shame, but as far as protecting yourself, I mean, you see a gun being pointed at you, it doesn't matter. It's your job to prevent killing.
Jeremy, let me ask you this. Would you have killed them too? Yeah, if you were the cop in that position at his rate and that up without the orange tip, would you have killed them? You know?
Yeah.
I have to be alive
here for my children, and I have to be here for my wife and children.
But you would have done
family.
It. You know? Well,
I had to. Yeah. Exactly. Now, I would have still thought it was unfortunate, but if a riot happened because of it, I would believe that people just wanted to be angry. Because it would be very obvious to me that that would be what anyone would do. You know, so people use
because
the playing game to release anger.
Think about this, though. Out of all the interactions we've had with police, you know, ourselves, like, what's the number one thing they want? Respect, right?
Respect.
You know, disrespecting them is the number one way to get an ass kick. You know? That's the number one way to get ass beat. You know?
Right.
And I can't say I blame, you know, because I put my own mind in their place. And if I was them, I would kick some ass too. You know? Do you agree with us on that? Can you see that too? You know, that, you know, it puts your mind in a cop's place. You know? If somebody disrespects you, would you beat their butt into the ground?
In every country are different. So from UK point, UK police are more trained differently than yours indeed. And so the things that may happen in your country, it may not happen at UK, or may things happen at the European Union, but it's different with UK, because since we are out of the, you know, European Union, so their laws are not applying to us anymore.
And I'm speaking, like, I'm proud of y'all for Brexit, you know? I've studied that. I've read a lot about that. But I don't know how you feel about that, but, I'm proud of that, you know? Y'all's country stood up for yourselves, you know? Let me throw that in, you know? I just wanted to
My name is Mazda. By the way, you know that in your country you have a blue strips American flag? So now they have changed the American flag to blue. And in favor of the police, that blue lives matter. So if you see that in your country, So I wanted just to let you know we are aware of that in UK as well.
What you feel about Brexit, though? Did you support that or not?
Can you repeat the question, please?
Oh, did you support, exit from the EU, of the UK, or not?
We support it 100%, because, you know, we don't want to be part of European Union, we don't want to be part of the New World Order, and we don't want it, you know, to bring more refugees than what we are going to bring from Syria and from Iraq. And then we are going to have the same problems as they are witnessing in Germany, in France, in the United States, so we don't want that. In UK as well. I mean, we are already in the mess as a result.
Now, see, I agree with him, Jeremy. Like, you know, like he's on the right path. What do you think about, like, in this in America with Donald Trump, like, and so forth, like, and his opinions? Do you agree with him?
Both of your Hillary and Donald Trump,
both of them are sold out. I know.
Are not good people.
Like,
both of them
if
are
you were forced,
both
if
them
somebody,
are
let me say this. If somebody put a gun to your head and said you're going to either vote for Donald Trump or you're going to vote for Hillary Clinton right now, which one would you choose?
I would take the gun away. You would take the gun away. That's all. That means we are not working
for
anything.
So you don't support
anything.
Either one of them.
None
I
of
agree.
Them.
They
both
got,
of them are correct.
You know,
both of them are bullshitters.
Jeremy has something to say. Let him jump in.
I don't mean to be harsh, man. But, like, every life matters, you know, and I believe that, like, that's the only thing that should be taught, you know, period. I mean, like, when people, like, not that they're not in a thinking in a bad place by saying black life matters or blue life matters or whatever, but, I mean, that's like backtracking in a way, because when did not every life matter? So they do this to get out of fear. They put these things up or out of trying to... say something that we should already know, you know, that's the problem, like, or is it money making, like the blue collar matter thing, you know, like everybody's life matters, every single person,
well,
you know. So,
I don't disagree, but like, I agree with where the man is coming from on certain things, you know.
I agree with him too. I just mean that you have to wonder, like, you have to take the good from whatever good, you know, comes out of whatever, because it's good. But at the same time, like, you know, like, every life matters, you know, every single one, like, wow.
That's true.
Who didn't know that, you know, and if we have to put something up like that, like, to remind people that, you know, it's only because of the situation, and maybe like, well, we're going to make it better if we do this, so everybody will calm down. But at the same time, like, every life matters, you know, like, period. You know, why blame?
I will tell you why all lives are matter is much better, because you can unite the people much better behind it than you say Muslim lives matter, Red Indian lives matter, Mexican lives matter, Black lives matter, lives matter. You know, it doesn't make sense. You know, it's more better for you guys to say one thing: all lives matter, and that's including blue lives matter too. So, but again, it's up to you people. It's up to you guys.
That includes
it's
blue
up
lives
to you
matter,
guys not to repeat
black
it again.
Black lives matter, white lives matter, European lives matter, everyone's lives matter. You know?
Right.
That's the whole thing. You know?
I mean, look, if a man hit my wife, I would instinctively be angry and want to hurt him. Now, if a policeman hit my wife, the same anger would be instilled inside me to do something, and maybe I wouldn't, because I fear that they could say, well, he hit, you know, I didn't do anything, you know, because of their control. That's the only thing because there's a different control thing there. But at the same time, you can't be mad at the man who'd be upset with somebody to hit his wife. You know, I mean, because that was instinctive inside, you know, is matters too. I mean, you know what I mean? Like, so basically, when people blow up, you know, because one man was killed and say Black Lives Matter, of course they do. But, you know, nobody ever said they didn't. And Cop Life Matters too. Nobody ever said they didn't. It's just that, you know, if you
let
one man
never
kill one man,
that no one's lives didn't matter. Never.
Right,
just,
you know?
Just in San Diego, two cops killed just last night. And there was a martial law style house to house search, and until they found
that's
the
way
second
suspect. That's the country too. You know,
right.
Like,
right.
That's what's from the west.
What we did here is amazing for us because, you know, in UK it's not like that. I mean, it's much more calmer,
much more police state. And, like, you know, this is much...
It's already,
this
because we have camera every
state.
Corner.
But the UK
we have camera in
the...
Everywhere we go, we are under camera. So, you know, we have used to it, and we have national ID cards. Once you have national ID cards, so they trust you more, because you have to go through a lot of, you know, at least give 20, 30 different characteristics about yourself to get that national ID card. So basically they investigate about you and they send you the card. Without it, you cannot rent. Without it, you cannot have bank accounts in Lloyds Bank or Barclays Bank or any of the banks in the UK. You cannot rent, you cannot buy. Basically, every time you use your national ID card.
Okay, let me ask you this. What do you think about the national ID card in the EU and the UK? You know, like, do you agree with that stuff, or do you?
If you are not agree with it, then I have to go sleep outside the door. You know what I'm saying? So if I want to have a place to stay, if I want to. You know, to be work or to have
what you feel in this, but, like, you know, because you're elite, you know, because of that, because of, like, what you're expected to say, it's hard to say, you know, I get that, you know.
No, 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 no. It's for us, it's, we have it for a long time. I mean, China has a national ID card. India has a national ID card. Egyptian has a national ID card. Israel has a national ID card. Yes, 100%. 100%. Because that, at least if you are a legal resident in the UK, then you basically you're screwed. You cannot buy anything. You cannot go place for rent. You cannot do anything. Then you wouldn't come to UK. Then you wait until your turn comes. Then you come legally.
When that happens, can you agree that that's police state when that kind of thing you just described happens? That's a police state. You know,
right.
that's an absolute police state. When that happens,
I mean, somebody has a higher control and it's so secure by doing that.
Unfortunately, we have it. We have it in right now. 4.8 billion citizens around the globe has a national ID card. Around the globe, Australia has a national ID card. Canada has a national ID card. I mean, Australia. So.
But you see, Matt,
let me jump in. The United States basically is leading that way. It basically has that in place right now. You know, now in Europe, Australia, so forth, it's more in the open. you know, here in this country.
And we are a cashless society. We are a cashless society, too. Really, we don't have cash that much in our wallet.
You said it was necessary, you said?
A cashless society.
Cashless.
Oh, okay.
Right.
All right, gotcha.
We are a cashless society, too.
Well, you know, I mean...
No, like, would you be... Let me ask this. You know, are you pro, like, you know, police state or not? You know, would you agree with the objectives behind all of this? Like, do you agree with them? You know, or do you have objection to the police state?
I mean, we have a total freedom in UK. I mean, nobody comes to bother me, and you know, I don't bother anybody either. So, from the police state,
and I'm not judging you.
From police state.
Keep on going.
That is a police state, you know, is something that every country has a police to take care of the criminals.
You know, you've seen, I know you've seen, like, other shows you've done. I know you have. Let me say this.
To take care of the criminals.
Some of this other stuff that we've done. I know you've seen. And let me say this. You know, like, you know your opinion of the police state. You know what it entails. You know what comes after that. You know the amount of control that entails. Now, can you support that amount of control? Like, honest question, you know? Can you support that amount of control?
I mean,
you support everybody being controlled for every little thought they think?
No. We don't have such a. We have the total freedom in UK, sir. I mean, you come to UK,
and
why are people being
arrested in the European Union? You know, like, for example, in France. You know, like, for making, like, certain statements of speech. You know, why is it in certain other countries besides France and the European Union? You know, and it's happened in the UK too. You know, where people are being arrested for free speech. Why?
Yeah, I mean, I'll tell you about the proper things to say. You know what I mean?
If there is a problem, they have been arrested. Maybe they have done something wrong. So
why is making a free speech statement wrong? That's what I don't understand about the UK. You know, like, why is somebody making a statement of free speech wrong?
I mean, I'm talking to you with freedom.
You know, like, why is that wrong? In this country, that doesn't work like that. You know, like, in this country, they're working towards that. You know, but in this country at this moment, it's not illegal, you know, for somebody to criticize somebody and then end up being arrested for it. Now, in the EU, in the UK, yeah, it does happen. You know?
Right.
I've seen too many.
In this country, like, when we get pulled over, right?
And I'm not disrespecting the man at all. I'm not disrespecting you at all. I just had to say that. I've seen the article. I've seen the news.
I don't even know why anybody would think we were against what he's saying. I mean, I think the man's totally right about everything he says, perfectly fine. Like,
yeah, I like this man. You know, like, you know,
I'm just talking about, like, we have to change.
How
like,
can
what
you
I'm
say
trying
that
to do.
You're forced to speech when you're our country resident for speech? You know?
I mean,
you can't, like, that's hypocritical. You know? You understand me, dude?
Fear, man.
You understand?
It's fear. It's instilled fear, like, because, I mean, anybody can talk. Anybody can say what they want, but they can't say certain things because they're afraid of what could happen. You understand, like...
Yeah,
but that
doesn't happen in this country, at least not yet. You know, that's
yeah,
what they're
working
for.
Yeah, but if you get pulled over, Matt...
You know?
And say you're a well-dressed man, right? You get pulled over, right? For running a red light. You have a whole lot less to worry about if you are well-dressed and nice and rich. Now, what if you have a beat-up car, long hair, tattoos and stuff? You might get searched and unjustly searched and because of a man's judgment, a policeman's judgment. What I'm trying to teach the whole world, everybody's equal, everyone, all the world. It doesn't matter what the rules are now, that the rules have to change. And the judgment is something that we're not allowed to have. We allow ourselves to have. You see what I'm saying? Like,
right. Let me jump in right here. I've read some news articles from Sweden. Yeah. All right. You know, and there is a man, like, you know, that was getting home invaded. You know? And, you know, this man's home was getting invaded, all right? You know, by a bunch of dudes, you know, with knives and guns. And
what?
Then he goes to stabbing, you know, like, you know, in self-defense. And then the dude gets 4 years in prison, you know, for excessive self-defense, unquote. You know, is that excessive self-defense to do that? You know? Like, what the hell is that? You know? Like,
that's because
why
we gave somebody else the ability to judge a life, you know, and what they did or how they did it, and if they get the ability to put them behind bars, like I'm saying, man, like, this is not a show about trying to prove.
I'm not
like,
criticizing them, but, like, excessive self-defense against that. What the hell is that? You know? Like, you know? I mean, that's not excessive self-defense.
Again, you have to read your
like
own constitution. Constitution,
you know?
Your constitution talks about your self-defense right there. I mean, you have to have a book of the constitution.
Do you agree,
with
that ruling that the man should have been locked up as he was, you know?
I mean, like, right, and that's horrible, that's wrong, and the Constitution's still there, so somebody has higher control regardless of the Constitution, you see what I mean? I mean, the Constitution would say absolutely not that man should be free, but at the same time, because somebody else did otherwise, you know, I mean, obviously he should be free, man. I mean, first off, we shouldn't be thinking we were able to invade a home. Second, if somebody invades your home, you have the right to kill them, especially if they have weapons, you know, and...
Yeah, they,
if
could,
a man
they had a gun, they had guns, knives, and then and stabbed them as excessive self-defense, you know? Like...
I mean, every time
that
judge go read the Constitution, I don't think he's going to change his mind. He's probably just a dick, you know what I mean?
I know he's not. I mean, the man is from another country. Like, you know, I understand that, you know, like, you know, like, I mean, this is the United States, and this is the UK, European Union, you know, where he's from, you know, I get that, you know,
man, I didn't say he was a dick, I'm talking about this man.
For stabbing people, for coming after you with a gun?
Oh,
I mean, that's not
Glasgow. In Ireland, we have a lot of that in Ireland. You know, Glasgow Island, oh my gosh, if you go at night after 8, 9 o'clock, you have a lot of stabbing in downtown Ireland, Glasgow. So, you know, it's happening around the globe. So, and the police comes and take the people to hospitals. So Glasgow, I mean, if you're a tourist in Glasgow, please don't go out after 5, 6 p.m. Please,
right.
Come to and your
then
hotel.
Then what are the tourists supposed to do when they're attacked? You know, let's say like somebody is a rapist comes and tries to rape.
Right.
Let's say that.
That's why we say we go.
You
go back
to
your hotel.
You know.
You go
then
back to your
are
hotel
you not
and kill you go back to your hotel at 6 p.m.
I mean, I'm just
PM.
Being honest. Yeah. Like, you know, like what is the limit of self-defense? That, you know, I'm just asking. You know,
I'm not from country.
I'm just asking.
We're just trying to explain to you, sir. I forgot your name, but like, isn't
Mazda,
it scary to know that? Mazda. Isn't it scary to know that we have a constitution in place with rules saying that we are allowed to protect ourselves, and then people, like on the news, we hear bans. Okay, got a home invasion. If people are threatening his life, he kills them, and then he goes to jail. That makes you wonder why.
People in this country, like in many states, like those laws, like if somebody even comes through the door, you're allowed to kill them on the spot. You know?
Right.
But most
you know,
of your problems
now,
are economic.
Europe,
most of your
work.
Problems are
yeah.
economic in general. Most of your problems are a lack of training. Most of your problems are because the mother works at night, father works in the morning, and the child is alone 24 hours, and that's what happens. And that's what happens when there is a liquor store every corner of your cities, and that's why liquor bring your system, bring you down.
But that's true. Fine.
So you're
blame,
trying to
blame, blame.
This is race. Okay.
But yeah,
you know,
true.
You know, let me jump in here. You know, like, I know
yeah,
you're trying to
paint
this as race. You know?
This is killing me.
So, let me jump in with this. You
go
know?
Ahead, this has become
what,
too much about...
you know, what you do? Now, if it's your own family, you know, somebody is running in your house, like, about to kill your family. What would you do? What would you do? Would you sit there and cower, you know, behind the shower curtain? You know? Would you sit there and cower it? Or would you take decisive action and put an end to the problem? You know? Like, that's just what I'm asking. You know? I'm not judging, again. The question might seem brutal, you know? But I'm just asking, you know, like, would you protect your family, or would you just sit there and hide?
Are you asking me, Mazda, or asking your friend?
First of all, we have very, very, very nice.
We have very nice police force in UK. I mean, once we get the call routed to them, they will be there within 3 minutes and three seconds. And I think three minutes and 3 seconds is enough time, really. Nothing that I can do or they can do against me, because they're going to go to jail. They're going to go. They're going to be captured anyway. So I don't know. Your country maybe the time is 12 minutes per call or something like that. That's a different story. But in UK, it's 3 minutes and 3 seconds. So with that, I mean, things we do.
Let's rephrase the question now. Who's the man that came into your house?
Before you say that, let me give you a little hint here. Like, you know, there's a saying in this country, you know, that, you know, like, when seconds count, the police are minutes away, you know? If somebody's invading your house with a gun into your head, the police are minutes away. That's a saying right here in this country. You know, Ben, what do you
How are you to get so, you know? How you get so thrown if they got a gun to your head, you know, to call the police, you know what I mean? Or if your wife says, hey, I will kill her if you move. You know, how does the people get there in seconds? I mean, if that man doesn't care if he goes to jail at all, he just shoots you all up and goes to jail and laughs about it himself. You know what I mean?
First of all, in United Kingdom, we don't have guns like you guys do.
I mean,
the chances are very low that that guy has a gun. So.
But what about the knife crimes? What about the knife crimes? What about all the knifings that go over, all over there that I've read about? What about that? Is there going to be, I'm asking logically, is there going to be knife control at what I've seen? You know, like people are chanting, like, save a life, turning a knife, and light marching down the street. I've seen those videos, you know? Like, what is going to work? What is going to work? You know, are baseball bats going to be controlled? You know? Like, what is going to work? You know? Like, I'm just asking logically. Yeah.
Yeah, logically, hypothetically. I mean, like,
that won't work, you know? Like, you think, like, you know, save a life, like, you know, throwing a knife, chance are going to work, you know? Like, somebody could strangle somebody. You know, that happens all the time, you know? Like, that's all it takes, you know? Like, or worse, you know? Like, you know? It doesn't take a gun, it doesn't take a knife, you know? I'm not trying to criticize the man. Go ahead, Jeremy, go ahead.
Oh, I hope he doesn't think that, period. I mean, I just think we're getting off track because we're trying to prove a point.
I know we are, but I feel like I've seen this before. Like, I've seen the ridiculous shit that goes on. Like in the EU, you know, and the UK, you know, now that, you know, they're independent of the EU, you know, like it just seems ridiculous, you know, compared to here. Like, you know, that people are punished for self-defense, you know, what is that, you know, I mean, that's
That's what I'm saying, man, like. That's what's scary, man, because even here, you know, that happens. People will rob a bank or a store, and the man will start running, had a gun to his face. The man will start running, and the guy will shoot him, hit him in the back. You know, I would have shot him.
Well, I don't have any problem with that either, you know?
Right,
like,
but that man
will go
to jail.
Like, you have to kill people who are against you. You have to do
right,
that,
but see,
you know?
Yeah, but these people go to jail because... You know, some written law, or maybe, you know, like to go up in front of the judge, and the judge is actually, like, you know, on weekends part of the KKK, and the black guy did nothing, he goes to jail, right?
Exactly.
That's scary. It doesn't matter where the Constitution lies. If people are human, and they have, regardless if they have good nature, bad nature, like, who decides who's right and wrong when they're trying to put them in an officer outfit? Or in a judge suit, you know, like, who decides that? Like, and can you really criticize them for being wrong sometimes? I mean, because they're only human. But at the same time, like, you know, if something's unjust, it's unjust. If somebody's trying to kill my family and I can't kill them, that's ridiculous. You know, I don't care, I'm going to kill them, you know, because I love my family. You know, I'll take the rap if that's the case. You know what I mean? I'm not afraid to protect because I love my family. Now,
Jeremy, can I jump in? Like, what do you think about that Sweden case where, like, the guy got 4 years in prison while the people attacking his family, you know, was at gunpoint and knife point, you know, like, you know, got probation? You know, like, you know, like, the guy self-defending himself and his family got more punishment. you know, and the people attack. What do you think about that?
Are you asking me?
No, I'm just asking you. You know?
Horrible, but at the same time, like, if you go into that country and you walk in, you ask that man who's behind bars, he's probably been through it. It's really what matters. I mean, because personally, I think it's horrible.
They have different laws than we do. I understand that. And the man said, you know, whatever country you go into, you have to obey their laws. You got to follow their policies. I get, you know,
yeah.
But I totally get that. That man's probably going to, at the same time.
He would have done it again, bro. He probably would have done it again and again, over and over. No fear of jail time, even though that's what they want. You know, I mean, that's where he's at. But to protect his family, he'd probably say to you, he would do it again and again. Now, do I think it's unjust? Of course. Yeah, does he? Probably so. But is he sitting in jail? Yes. Would he do it again? Probably so. You know, the problem is, you know, everybody's still thinking in a certain way. The problem is somebody's got to step in and change it, you know. The obvious answer is protect your family. You know, other than that, you live in fear. Of fear of what? You know, jail? You know, over your family?
I'm not even criticizing the EU or, you know, the UK. You know, I'm just making an objective observation. You know,
yeah,
that
I'm criticizing individuals.
I see something about
a country.
Test of self-defense. Like, excessive self-defense. You know? But, I mean, that's ridiculous. You know?
Do you have any question for me before I leave you guys? Because, I have to go.
I understand, bro. We're not criticizing. You know, coming from a perspective from this country, I guess. You know, you're coming from a perspective from your country. You know? And we're not criticizing.
I'm trying to take myself out of the mindset of any country, any law, any rule. I mean, just things that, you know, like we're instilled with ways of thinking from here to the other side of the world that are doing us no good. And the problem is, until we find a way to realize that, you know, we are the only ones that control that thinking, and we're the only ones that can make it stop for the future generations or for tomorrow, we have to be able to, either change it and show and dedicate our life to showing that we can, or, you know, go ahead and suck it up and do what you believe regardless of the consequence. You know, and that's the kind of thing. And if you get killed over it, that's ridiculous, you know, but constitutional or not, or any country's law or not, I mean, you got to do what you believe, really, or otherwise you probably really don't believe in it, you know what I mean?
Jeremy, what were you saying about Glasgow, you know, a little while ago?
About what?
In Glasgow, if you go after 7 p.m., in downtown Glasgow Island, you know, is basically people are fighting together, whether it's the political parties, whether are fighting for the girl, or fighting on some kind type of fighting, and it's very dangerous place downtown Glasgow after dark. So for you tourists, if you ever come to Glasgow, please go back to your hotel by 6 p.m. and don't come out until right, tomorrow morning.
Let me ask you about Glasgow, really about Ireland in general. You know, is the war still going on there? Like, you know, does that still go on there? Like, and you know what I'm talking about.
The war is not going on, but still the people in Glasgow, tense. They have high emotions, you know. So easily.
That's a good question. Do you believe that fighting solves anything? I mean, just personally, do you believe fighting? Does it solve any problems, fighting, you know? Really, I mean, like, you know, because, I mean, like, if somebody, no, just in general, does fighting solve any problems?
No, they haven't disappeared yet in the downtown Glasgow yet. I mean, people are come there and having good time, you know, because in Glasgow we drink beer lots.
People are a little bit
drunk.
All right, what about downtown London? What about
downtown London?
Like, you know, there's been outbursts in downtown London, you know?
Downtown London is more open. It's not as bad as Glasgow Island, you know? And downtown Island, you can go walk 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the morning and have no problems.
And why is that? You know that there's no problem.
Because they have more police force they put there in the night times, and also, you know, because of tourism, and a lot of tourists come from European Union, so therefore they want to protect everyone.
Brutalizing people. There to make sure, tourism is enforced. Like, it's a logical question. You know, I'm not judging anyone. You know,
let me explain something. The thinking processes are always off because it's not anybody's fault. But, like, if you're walking down the street where nobody's beating you up and you're thinking about, oh, I lost my woman to this man, your problems are there in your mind. You're still carrying your problems just because you don't have people beating you up.
But the thing is, Jeremy, to create a situation like that. No, wait. Somebody has to be scared of somebody, you know? Like, you know, to walk through the streets of downtown Glasgow, Scotland, you know, if you're going to walk through those streets in the middle of the night, you know, somebody has to be scared of somebody, you know? Who's scared of who, you know? That's what I'm saying, psychically is that, they're scared of the cops, you know, what they're going to do to them, you know? Like, and I'm not condemning the cops either when I say that.
I would be scared of the drunk guy that's going to beat me up or my girlfriend. I'm just saying, even after he beat me up,
like, those cops beat the fuck out of people. I get that.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm with you.
I mean, if you get beat up in Glasgow and then you walk down the nice street, you still lost your girlfriend. The problem's still there. Black eye, no black eye. Death or no death, right? Money problem.
And the
all
cost of life, many people with black eyes and whatnot, but I'm not condemning them for that either. You know?
But
that's what they've been awarded.
But the deeper issues need to be solved. I mean, shoot, you can go around this place where people fight. How do you free yourself of hurt inside or anger or the, you know, those things that make you go out there and fight?
Ireland, Jeremy, Ireland is deep in anger, man. Like, it's just embedded in anger. Like, there's been so much fighting there, so much shit there.
Yeah. There's so much shit there. That's true. You don't want to go to Ireland at all. Just stop by London, Bournemouth, and over there, Southampton, is a great place for you guys. Please don't go to Ireland. Please don't, Ireland, especially Glasgow, is a piece of crap. You don't want that. And
I walk right in the midst of Scotland, you know, any over there, you know. I'm not scared of anybody. And, you know, my style is to understand the and, you know, I get that if I walk the streets of Ireland myself, I'd end up meeting the opposition, you know. I would end up meeting, you know, my own enemy. And, you know, and we could find a common ground, you know. My style is to speak to my enemies, you know, to speak to them, you know, to try to understand why they think the way they do. That's
yeah. I mean, it's not going to change. Yeah, it's not going to change in a day. And you might get beat up. If you look in America, somebody steals your girlfriend or whatever, they're going to come looking for you wherever you're walking. I mean, they're going to, you know, they might shoot you over.
I think what would happen if I walked the streets.
I mean,
I'd be walking. You know,
all I'm
like
saying,
they
is
want
not
to get their messages.
Anyway, my friends, I have to go. I have to go, and I wanted to say to you guys that...
Can I say this? That's an honor to have you on here, you know?
Yeah,
like,
thank you, man.
Understand
thank
that
you. Yeah,
we're not anti-anything, you know?
We're trying to find a solution.
Just take the message with you. We're not anti-anything, you know?
Nothing.
Like...
Yeah, you're welcome. But I hope you guys listen to your police. I hope you listen to your police. You'll be, be nice to your police and hope your police be nice to you too. So no more killings of any kind will happen. So peace, all lives are matter, and peace be upon your nation.
Peace be upon you too.
Thank you. Thank you for the good,
Thank you, man.
It's us, Jeremy. We outplayed, you know, you understand that, you know?
There's no answer.
What has happened, you know? You understand that, you know?
Right.
You
absolutely.
You know, I
guess.
But at the same time, he was told to enforce a message. I get that. You know,
mm-hmm.
Was instructed, we're going to do this and that, you do this and that. You know, I know you're still listening. You know?
Yeah. I mean, that's the thing.
And I'm not judging you either. Scaring out words.
He's right.
You know,
I guess what I was trying to say is my thought patterns are not anything to do with the police Oh, well, I mean,
exactly, but we had to go into that, you know? I had to address it, you know?
But we have to find a solution that we can pass.
I had to go after, like, you know, I had to make sure that the Black Lives Matter movements and Blue Lives Matter movements were not sabotaged. I'm not judging anymore. And our message has been made clear here tonight.
That's right.
It's very clear. You know, like, we're not against anybody. Like, y'all heard me. Like, you know, like, I'm inviting callers to call. I want cops to call to the show. I want them. Y'all calling the show. But, like, I want y'all to do it more. You know? Like, you know, against y'all, you know, or Jeremy is against y'all, you know? But, you know, we take everybody.
Rome wasn't built in
there, man. We're a little smarter than some people, you know? Let me say that. I'm going to shut up a bit. Let me speak.
No, you're all right, man. I just feel like, I mean, look, regardless of who it is, you have to implant a solution. Because otherwise,
and
they can't
avoid
it once the truth. Once the truth is there, they can't avoid it regardless who they are. I mean, human emotion is in everybody. It doesn't matter.
The truth has gone out tonight, and they couldn't stop. You know?
Right.
The truth is, you know, they can't avoid us. They cannot stop us.
But they might still question what our teachings might be, Matt. That's what I'm worried about, because we're here to
do
something.
Who cares?
No.
Who cares?
Well, I know that.
Our energy is implanted in them. Who cares? You know?
Well,
like,
exactly.
once we've planted those seeds of our energy in them, they have no control. You know?
That's what I'm saying. I'm never even doubting that they have any control over me, man. And, I mean, it's not that I care about so much what anyone thinks. I'm just talking about, like, as a spiritual teacher, I want to give an answer. You know, like, you know, they're there to throw us off. They're there to make us feel like on guard. You know, so we have to somehow.
Can I jump in real quick? Let me jump in real quick. Like, I know y'all just tried to sabotage my cat buddy against me, you know? He turned to my lap and almost shut off the communication. You know? Are you with me now?
That's what I'm worried about. Like,
they're going after us, but keep going.
Yeah,
don't
the truth
stop.
Is still going to come out still. Like, we have to
change.
We have to change our thought pattern, man. You know what I mean?
Don't stop.
Like,
I've already got them. I've got them. Don't worry. You know? Like, they tried to sabotage my cat buddy. You know, he was sleeping right on my lap. Like, you know, like, he kept throwing his paw, like, on the end button. You know? Before, like, I tossed him off my lap. And I knew y'all were trying to do that. I knew it. So don't try to fool me, y'all. You all can go fuck yourself very much.
It's now. I mean, yeah. I mean, you know, like, I mean, look, man.
That's
like,
right.
Just doing,
they're just doing their job, too. You know?
I feel like they're just doing their job too.
Like, I've seen them use everything against us. Everything. You know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to stay fucking shocked. You know?
But they're just doing their job, though, and
we have a permanent record of this shit right here. You know? You think I'm going to be silent? Hell no. You know? Like, God damn, though. You know, it's like, and even Buddy understands it. Like, you know, I kind of like flipped him off my lap and he got it. You know, like, you know, like he woke up to the realization of control. that fucking control grid. You know? Like, now, I'm sorry, Jeremy. I had to rant. That shit pissed me the fuck off. It's, you know, like, hey, you know? This is how we should do a show, Jeremy, bro. Like, you know, you see how we took the Oppo on? You know? Now, you see that?
Yeah.
Let's speak about that. But you're like, you know, that was the Oppo right there. You know? Like, and yet, we sat for an hour engaging the Oppo. You know? Like, and...
I talked to Oppo.
It's,
you know,
lucky,
like,
I keep up with news and all that stuff, you know, from alternative viewpoints from other countries, you know? So I have a counter viewpoint to him, you know? So
I mean, that,
I know,
as long as they can keep you out,
and it,
as long as they can keep you occupied, listen, as long as they can keep us occupied with,
that's what they're doing.
Right.
Go ahead.
We're not going to be able to speak the truth, you know what I mean? Because we're too busy trying to prove.
Let's speak it out now. Speak the truth.
Fuck
the
Oppo.
No, speak.
They can't deny the truth. Like, we got to put implant truth. Like, if they want to deny it and keep on doing their job to prevent us from doing something, like, you know, we're still fan fuck them, man.
You think with that we did succeed at what we just did? You know? We did. You know? We implanted a lot of people. There was a lot of people listening. And they were implanted with little seeds of knowledge. You know? Whether they knew it or not. So, let's go on. You just said, what were you about to say? Like, forget about everything else.
Well, before the man even called, we were just talking about, you know, how things are going as far as the cop and all that individual. Everybody's thinking in all that situation, every situation I can almost think of, even a climbing the windows with knives or getting a job to be the Oppo or whatever, they all have a reason, and a good one in their own minds. But the problem is, they had no other ideas to debate in themselves. So if we implant the ideas, they can't deny what's true. You know what I mean? So the thing is, the judgment thing, man, like, are you serious? Like, you can judge, like people say, you know, judgment, don't do it, or judge, be judged, or whatever. But, like, you know, we can't say who's right or wrong. So personally, I believe in their judgment. Like, drop the judgment. It's not going to happen today. But until everybody does it, you know, it's not going to happen, period, you know. But, you know, it doesn't pay enough money.
And look what I did.
You know what I mean?
Look what I did.
It doesn't pay enough money.
You know, I went straight against, like, the party line of Black Lives Matter by saying, you know, that if I was the cop, like, you know, that killed a 12-year-old, you know, like, you know, that it was, I went straight against their party. Yeah, and yet I support them. isn't that interesting?
Yeah,
you know, that
I
can support them, and while at the same time, I don't.
Right. Yeah, exactly. I mean, you can see both sides of that. You know, because, you know, yeah, somebody pointed a gun at you, I mean, you got to protect yourself. But like
God,
I think
right. I would have killed them.
But it's just sad that people could use it as an excuse to hate all cops, you know, because they, like,
and
for instance,
they're
going to
use what we've done tonight against us. I know that, too. You know, but it's our job to be controversial, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
you think
like
the
he's the country does this. He's your country does this. I'm like, yes. All right, get past that. We know. Blame. But now what? You know what I mean?
See, I roll right with them, too. You know? It's not, I mean, I didn't hang them up or anything like that. Like, I just kept going with them. And remember, right before I put them on the air, I said, this is a troll call, you know? And I knew it was. I looked at it, and he was, you know? But, like, you know, a different, a very, very different kind of troll call, you know? Like a troll caller I expect, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
like,
but if we're right,
at
if
least
we're right,
he made
the
some valid
have
points.
To start. I mean, humans, man, have emotion.
I've got to look at your championship. So, you know, like where he said, like a 5-year-old, a cop in Jamaica killed a 5-year-old. You know, like,
man,
you
I'm
know,
not down
like I've got to look at
you know that, man. I'm down with talking about anything. I was just saying, like, you know, I'm down with talking about anything, you know. But, like,
a troll caller I can't respect is somebody who goes on the air and screams and yells and disrupts shit. Like, a troll caller I can respect is somebody who goes on there and tries to present their beliefs and their facts, you know, from their viewpoint. You know, even better trolls, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Like,
I mean, they're doing
that.
Their job.
You
man.
Know, that's why I kept the last man on the air. You know?
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
You know, even though I knew what the point was, you know, he was kept on the air for a reason. You know? Like,
I'm
you think Jeremy and I think Jeremy and I are fucking stupid. We're not.
No.
You know? You think
that you know us,
like, we're going to use you, you know, and you won't know when you're being used. You know that.
I don't care what the Oppo is saying, man.
You know?
I know, but...
Like, I hate the opposition, man. You know?
But they want to
like,
make
we're against,
talk.
Like, the fight of our fucking lives. You know? Like, but
they're trying
can
to make you angry, bro.
Every little turn. You know? Like,
said nothing.
That's what the cool thing
is.
I know I'm not a good people. You know? But I want to make sure it's rubbed in anyway. You know? Like,
I mean, they're just doing their job.
You're not smarter than us. You are not smarter than us. Believe me. I've seen this live on fucking national radio. You are not smarter than us. You can use all the fine techniques you want. You can use all the techniques you want. And you still won't win. That's what I have to say to y'all motherfuckers. Now, you see, Jeremy, man, that's a good idea that you're on the air tonight, isn't it? You know?
I'm sorry.
Like,
yeah, I mean, I'm
hey,
just,
you see
I'm
how savage I am now? They're going to use it against us. They're gonna do their best to use what we said tonight against us. I know that.
I mean, what's the worst they could do to us? I'm not scared of it, you know? What's the worst they could do, huh?
Hey, we're about to destroy them, you know? So, you know, it's funny, like, you know, that they let us access onto the radio tonight. Isn't that interesting? You know, they thought we would self-destruct. That's why they let us on the radio. I get that, y'all. You know? To the y'all on the opera. I understand that. You know, I would have done the same thing. I would have let the enemy get enough rope to hang themselves. You know, that's what y'all tried to do to me and Jeremy. But it didn't work.
I mean, they always know they're so wrong, man. They always know. They can't defeat their hearts, man. They know.
Good.
They're getting paid or something to prevent something from happening. Period. You know what I mean? Like, you know, fuck them, man. You know, if we say we're smarter, they'll say no, you're not. If they, you know, they want to, they're not going to, you know, I mean, like, there's no reason.
They're trying to give us enough rope Salisbury. That's it. You know, like, and guess what? We took that rope and hung it up, you know? So, too bad, y'all. Too fucking bad. Yeah, this is the time, like, where we go after these stupid piece of shit motherfuckers. You know?
Go after them for what, though, man? Fuck them, man. Don't worry about them. You're a spiritual teacher, man. Fuck them.
Yeah, we are spiritual teachers, but we're brutal spiritual teachers at the same time. Like,
but we gotta teach,
you
man.
Know? Like, people, followers of mine have seen enough brutal shit on my time. You know, for me. You know? So, like, you know, I'm not afraid to be cruel. You know? I'm not afraid to do anything to start opposition. I'll do anything. And you, like, let me say, Jeremy is more lenient than I am. You know? Like, but I'm not criticizing him or anything. But, you know, I mean, right, it's the truth, right? You know, you can be more lenient than I am. You know?
I mean, no, I agree with you, man. I just think that we can say it 1,000 times, but we got to stay on track. You know what I mean? They're doing that on purpose.
Yeah, do you think, like, I let that dude on the air? Like, without, like, bucking him off the air, or, like, for no reason? You think like, I let him on the air for a reason. Like, to hang himself with his own rope. You know? That's why I did that. You know? I didn't say that on the air. You know? Before. But I wanted him to hang himself. You know? You know? With his own statement. That's what I was waiting for him, like, you know, to hem himself up on lies, you know? Like, I was just waiting for him to be caught up in lies and to hang him, you know? Like, I just gave him just enough rope to hang himself. So, you know, I could have communicated to you, you know, like, without the album knowing. You know, like, but I wanted him to hang himself, you know, so, Now, do y'all think Jeremy and I are a force to be fucked with? You better think we are. You better be the fuck afraid of us. You hear that, you stupid motherfuckers?
Okay, are we staying on the air, man?
I'm with you. Yeah, they're trying to interrupt us. I get that. I'm tuning in with them, too. You know? Like, but do you see the need to go after them at that level, you know, that I do? You know? I mean, I just, like, y'all, I'm like, me and Jerry are discussing shit here. Like, we go after shit different ways. But don't you see the need to do that? You know? To go after them at that level. You know? You see, like, what I do is no holds barred. You know? And we're still live on the national radio scene. I don't care. Okay. You know?
I was trying to tell that man, so he would know, man, like, what we demonstrate, you know, it has to be important how we act. And, you know, I mean, there's 100,000 other people that need to learn from us, you know, and to be able to get rid of the offer, man, they got to know that all of them, including them, and those 1,000 people, and you know, are dealing with things wrong already. You know, and so somebody higher and powerful and more intelligent can teach them, not even themselves, to you know, will be able to deny. money can't change it. There's no real good reason to stop us. You know.
Man, we kicked some real shit tonight, man. Like, you see how, like at one moment, like I'm supporting, like, Black Lives Matter, for example. And then the next moment, you know, like, I'm agreeing, you know, with the troll, you know? Like, you know, saying, like, well, even if a five-year-old pointed a gun at me, I would kill him. And I mean it, you know? Like, I want cop callers and everybody else callers to call, you know? Like, yeah, I want cops to call, you know? I want to talk, you know? Like, you know, I want to hear from people. Can't be afraid to be political either. You see how I flew into politics and in the middle of that, you know? Like, we can't be afraid to go that way, you know? Like, you know? I mean, although, like, even the troll caller agreed that it's right, you know? And, like, he flat out, that's right on tape, you know? Like, he agreed it's all right. You know, but it still has to be called out. I'm going to be political if need be, and well, tonight it was need be. You know, I'm like that's why I asked him. I'm like, you know, what's your opinion on Brexit? Like, what do you think about, like, is the EU? You know, like going out of the, the UK going out of the European Union, you know, do you support it or do you not? And I had asked him, remember, I had to reinforce that question a few times, you know, before he gave me an answer, you know, but that he did support, you know, and then remember, I congratulated him for supporting that. And now I know Jeremy, man, like, you might not have, like, kept up the speed on all of this, you know? Like, I keep track of all this shit, you know? But,
yeah.
You know, it's just like, I watch this shit. Like, and, you know, like, so I'm prepared to deal with people from other countries. That's the reason why, you know? Like, because I know I'm going to get callers from other countries. And, you know, I have to know about what's going on in their countries. And so you think I'm not going to, y'all think I'm not going to be smart and study up on that shit, you know, and see what's going on. That's why I was going after him so hard with the Sweden story, you know? Like, that was big news, Jeremy, you know? Like, excessive self-defense. Like, for stabbing somebody who's trying to kill somebody who's trying to shoot. You know? You know?
Yeah,
like,
I'm sure, like,
what the hell is that? You know? Like,
yeah.
You know? He tried to use it as a distraction after I brought it up. He was turned around on it, you know?
Yeah. It's like people are blamed. I guess what a scary bottom line is, like, we blame somebody, or they broke in our house, that's the reason we killed them. You know, like, it's never, whatever reason, man, it's probably not that fun to have to kill somebody, you know, regardless, you know. You see what I'm saying? Like, the person coming in had something in their mind that was wrong.
He did say, like, you know, whatever country you're in, you got to respect their laws and whatnot. I get that. I get it all the way. You know?
Let's think about the guy optimistically that went in and tried to kill people. You know, like, where was his head at? You know, like, he probably thought he was in the right, you know, like, most likely. You know, or thought he was entitled to do so. Or, you know, something was wrong with him, like he wanted money or something, right? You know, so he did that. And
he was paid off to do that. And, like, you say that a little bit there. You know, like, I know y'all that they, well, not y'all, that, well, let me say this. Y'all got paid to pay him, you know, to do that. And, you know, isn't it funny? After my last radio show, it was about the Brits, you know, using, sleazy techniques to go after talk show hosts. That we happen to have a Brit caller calling in, you know? Like, and we're engaging for over an hour. Isn't that convenient? that's all I have to say, Jeremy. You know?
We probably got to cut the show, man, don't we?
We're down to four minutes here on the air. Let's cut it off here, man. Call me back after this, man. I'm going to cut it off. Like, I just have to run a couple things by you, you know? Like, is that cool?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to call you.
All right, let me cut it off here. I'm going to call you right back, all right?
Or should we tell, thank you guys for listening, and we hope whatever you hear, you feel the realness. You feel that nothing's going to come between our beliefs and what we do. And it's an adamant feeling, and the more you listen, the more you're going to receive. You know?
Absolutely.
All the operators keep on calling and interrupting, you know, beware, because it's getting planted in your head.